Alrighty, welcome everybody to another video. Today we are at Epcot. It has been a couple months since we've last been here. It's towards the end of October, so this is our first visit to Epcot. We wanted to see Food and Wine Festival. We do want to try some new items. Kind of have an idea of what I want to try, and we're just gonna have fun today. We're just gonna walk around. Another thing too is that I am still running today. Well, today is a Sunday, so it is normally my long run day. I am still running. I know I haven't updated much on my running status. I am still running the Walt Disney World Marathon in January. So I'm a little tired today. I ran 11 miles earlier today, which is actually, this is actually a lower week. A little sore today. I'll see how it goes walking around the World Showcase. Just wanted to give you guys an update on that, but I am still planning on running the Walt Disney World Marathon. One thing I'm looking forward to is going to the expo that they usually have, because they usually have pretty good booths there with vendors and everything. And it's just the atmosphere. It's fun. I mean, that's where I'll pick up my bib. I do plan on recording it. I'm still not sure exactly how or what, but that's coming up soon. So it'll be here before we know it. And then the other thing is we have a cruise again. We keep talking about it. We're gonna have a fortnight on the Wish Maritime Christmas cruise, and I'll be doing a cruise vlog for you guys. So stay tuned for all those things. So we're actually gonna go right now and walk over to the World Showcase. Alrighty, so first order of business today is we're gonna head over to Creations. Juliana was looking for something specific. She is looking for a keychain, a Cinderella keychain. I'm guessing she said she saw this at school. And so I guess she wants the same thing. All right, so we are in Creations shop. If you know me, I can never get it right. I always get Creations and Connections mixed up. I can see it the other way around too. Creations, I like to eat people's creations and I like to connect with items. So I don't know, my brain doesn't work properly, but here we are, we're looking for that keychain. And I guess Ezra wants one now too. So we'll see, I'll show you guys what we end up walking out of here with. Look guys, they already have Christmas stuff out. Haven't even had Halloween yet. We already got the lounge fly and the ears. Got more Christmas stuff here. And obviously I didn't even notice the stuff over here too. They've already got the sweatshirts out, the spirit jerseys here, if you're curious. I'll kind of take a look at one of them here. Yeah, I know, right? While we're at it. So we already have Christmas merch. And in here we got some snowmen. We got snow Mickeys, snow Mickey ears, and a snowman, snow Mickey lounge fly. All right, there's actually a whole wall over here. They already have the train set. And a Christmas Mickey over here. Is it too soon for Christmas stuff? Same question about the Halloween things. Is it too soon for this? All right, well, I'm gonna say no. I think I actually like the Christmas stuff coming out now. I know you might say it's gonna ruin it, it's too soon, but I don't know, it gets me excited for it. I'm not actually gonna go home and put my tree up right now, but I like seeing that the stuff is finally coming out, so. All right, so no luck in Creations. We couldn't find what Juliana was looking for, so we're gonna go towards the World Showcase and start eating food. We're hungry, I'm hungry at least. Alrighty, so we are choosing to go right today because maybe there's some hope that France will have something Cinderella related. So we'll check the shops there and see if they have anything and eat along the way. All right, we're gonna actually pop in the port of entry and see what's in here. Alrighty, kind of loud over here, but as usual at Food and Wine Festival, it's a little crowded today. It's a Sunday, so I guess as expected, there's gonna be a little bit of a weekend crowd, but we're making it through the crowds. But we went through some of the flowers that were here in the UK Pavilion. The kids wanted to see some flowers. We're actually also doing a little bit of preschool walk here, or kindergarten. Juliana's supposed to do nature walks, so she wanted to walk through the flowers and look at those. So we did, beautiful flowers. The weather's not too bad today. It's a little hot in the sun, but it feels nice with the breeze, so. Thank you. All right, so we walked around France. We didn't see what Juliana was looking for, and I have a feeling what she's looking for might not be what she thinks it was. She saw it on the lounge fly backpack, so we'll see. So we're gonna go walk around. We need to get some food. Anyway, hopefully I'll be able to see soon what it was she was talking about, and we'll know what she's trying to find. So right now we're gonna go, I think we need to go to a booth now. I'm hungry. I'm sure you're hungry too. So let's go find somewhere to eat. All right, so I'm in line now in Brazil. We're gonna get some cheese bread. The kids really like this. We've had it last year. We got two sets of it, so I'm gonna do the same for them because I know they will eat this for dinner, so. All right, so we got the cheese bread for the kids. I'm gonna go bring it over to them now. So if you want my analysis on these, you can just check out my video from last year. This is the same. The kids really enjoyed it. It's cheesy, soft, gooey. But check out that video if you want to see what it was like eating these cheese breads. So enjoy, guys. Oh. Alrighty, so I'm in line right now in Japan. I'm gonna get their eel tamaki sushi here. This will be the first item I'm getting for food and wine, so I'll show that to you guys here in a minute. Thank you. Alright, so this is the eel tamaki sushi. It's supposed to be like a hand sushi, so you hold it by the seaweed wrap. It looks like it's open face, it's grilled eel. So I guess I've never had grilled eel before, so I'll let you know how this tastes. All right, so this is gonna be a little hard to try to eat this and record it at the same time because it's hard to grab. It's very full. I don't wanna break the seaweed. Okay, here I go, I got it. I'll try to take a bite here. I love seaweed. It's actually pretty good. It tastes like sushi. It's a bit messy though. The egg crumbles that are all over it have gotten all over my leg. The sauce is kind of squeezing out, so now I got sticky sauce in my hand. So good thing I do have some napkins in the stroller, so I'm gonna eat this. I'm gonna shut this camera off and I'll talk a little bit more afterwards. All right, so like I said, the sushi was actually really good. When you look at it though, it doesn't look as appetizing as it tastes. The eel still looked a little kind of slimy and weird, so I just didn't look at it and I ate it and it was delicious. So I definitely recommend you try that. Alrighty, we're in the flavors of America, because Tiffany and I want to try the hot dogs they have here. So this is new this year at Food and Wine Festival. Alrighty, so here I have the Chicago style dog, and then this one is the New York style dog. So Tiffany and I got them. I guess we'll try a little bit of each other's. It looks good. Alrighty, so hot dogs are consumed. I just ate the Chicago style one. Tiffany ate her New York style one. I did try a little bit of the caramelized onion topping from her hot dog, and it was good, but her only complaint was it was just a lot. If you looked at the video, it's like clumped up right in the middle, so you basically get, at least when you get to the middle, a mouthful of toppings. So hopefully you like caramelized onions. The Chicago dog was really good. Similar thing, but you know, it was still delicious. I got mustard all over me, but I enjoyed it. So if you like those, they also have two other dogs, hot dogs there. The Chicago and New York style appealed to us the most, but they all sound good. So hopefully you guys enjoy that. Stop on over here if you want a hot dog. Aurora wants to give a review of the yummy bar she just ate. What do you think, baby? What do you think about it? She recommends it. She definitely recommends it. She doesn't know where it came from, but get some. All right, so it's a little later right now. We're walking past the refreshment outpost. I'm gonna stop here and get a chocolate Amarula mousse. Like a zebra cake. It's something that Tiffany's been wanting to try, so we're gonna get in line right now and get that. There we have the chocolate Amarula mousse. I'm gonna give this to Tiffany so she can have it. So the outside has some mousse here, and then we get the fork out of the way, and the inside's got like a chocolate cake. And I guess this is like a biscuit or a cookie. So I took a little sample of it, and I actually like this pretty good. It's cold. It's nice and cold, so it's good for a hot day. It's a good dessert for cooling off. And it's chocolate, so if you like chocolate, try this thing. All right, so the sun is setting. It's starting to feel a little nicer here. We are actually gonna walk over to Norway, something that the kids haven't done. I don't know if they've never done it or they just haven't done it in a long time, but we're gonna do the Frozen ride. So I'll get to actually record that one for you guys. So we're almost there. So we just finished riding the Frozen ride. I had this little girl on my lap, and she did good. They all did good. I thought Ezra might have been scared a little drop, but he said he did good. He liked it. What'd you think of the ride, buddy? Hang on, it's not looking at you. What'd you think? Okay. All right, so we're perusing the shops right after Frozen ride. I think right now what we need to do is get Aurora, probably get her nursed. So I think we're gonna walk over to the Odyssey Pavilion and Tiffany's gonna go nurse her. So let's head that way now. All right, so right now I'm sitting in the baby care center. There's a little waiting room off to the side. Tiffany's nursing Aurora right now, so I'm gonna hang out here. I would go walk around a little bit more, but I'm tired, so I just, 11 miles is catching up to me, so I'm just gonna sit here and relax. We're probably gonna get one more item before we leave to eat. We were gonna go watch Hanson perform tonight, but we didn't really time it very well. We kind of passed them after they started. We did Frozen. They're already starting the second show, and we're not going to stay that late tonight. So we're not going to get to watch Hanson tonight. That's what we were originally going to do tonight. But, you know, we don't want to backtrack, and really the kids are tired. So we'll get one more food item. Bring that to you guys when we do. I'm dead tired after this, and we're going to go home. So I'm going to hang out here. Let's watch some more Cars stories here. Okay, so the sun has settled. We're done in the baby care center. Like I said, we want to get one more thing. We can actually hear the concert on the other side of the World Showcase going right now. We can hear Hanson playing, but all of us are tired. Ezra's stubbornly still walking, even though he looks tired, his eyes are. Yeah, I know. We got the pickle milkshake last time. We're not gonna do that today, this year. We're not gonna do that today. So I really don't know what we're gonna eat, but let's walk around a little bit. Alrighty, I'm getting in line in the Flavors of Fire cart to try their smoked corned beef. All right. All right, right, so it's kind of dark, but we got the Impossible Slider here. The cashier who rung me up said that was actually one of her favorite things. Plus, she said this was... I asked her about the burger versus this, and she said definitely go with the corned beef. So it's got corned beef, chips, I don't know what else on there. Cheese, fondue cheese. Alrighty, so I just finished eating that corned beef meal. They're smoked corned beef, and it actually was really good. So it was a good recommendation. I actually think that was probably my favorite thing today that I tried, and I wasn't even planning on coming here. So if you like corned beef kind of things, it's really good. And just to describe it so you know, it's basically a base of potato chips, like freshly fried potato chips, with corned beef, like fondue cheese. I can't remember if there's something else on there, but it's really, really good. And a little messy, but, you know, just have some napkins ready. Definitely recommend that one for sure, though, and it's a good price. It's like $6.50 for that one, so. I think we're going to get one more item because the kids didn't want anything from there. So we're actually at, and I'll turn the camera around, the Fry Basket. I don't know if they want to, but they've liked it in the past, the Fry Flight.
Let me tell you about the
and
fry.
And here's the Fry Flight. Oh, it's kind of dark.
There's three different kinds of fries you get. There's a truffle fry.
So we're going to get the Fry Flight. All right, cancel that. Juliana does not want a Fry Flight. She wants a hamburger. So, and she specifically said she wants to go to the place behind the playground, which indirectly I'm sure she means to Connections Cafe. So we're going to go to Connections, get a little hamburger for her, maybe some food. I'm still a little hungry, so maybe I'll eat something there too. And then we're going to go because it is very late. Kids, past kids' bedtime, past my bedtime. And we had a lot of fun today though, so I'll close out in a little bit. Let's go get some food. All right, I didn't record eating here in Connections. The kids are a little bit off the rocker. They're tired, but I'm dead tired. Probably won't try to do this too often, run 11 miles and then come to Epcot again. But we're gonna go home now, so I'm in the video here. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoy this kind of content, please consider subscribing and liking this video and do all those things that you do. Please share my videos. And yeah, I'll catch you guys in the next video. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye for now.